Sabi nila, age doesn't matter, lalo na sa pag-ibig. Pero ganun din ba sa kaso ni Ronald Cardema ng Duterte Youth na gustong kumatawan sa mga kabataan sa Kongreso kahit lagpas na sa itinakdang edad ng batas? Richard Haydarian weighs in on this issue.
From National Youth Commission Chair to incoming Congressman of the Republic of the Philippines. So guys, ano pakialam natin when it comes to the change in work status ni Ronald Cardema? First, recap! Before siya ma-appoint bilang chair ng National Youth Commission of the Philippines, si Ronald Cardema ay leader of the so-called Duterte Youth Movement. Remember those handful of dudes who rallied in support of the Marcos burial? Pa-aerial shot naman dyan! From the Duterte Youth Movement, he was appointed as the chairperson of the National Youth Commission. As NYC chair, naging notorious si Cardema dahil sa kanyang aggressive stance laban sa student activists. In fact, he wanted to remove the scholarships ng quote-unquote rebellious anti-government scholars. Now, from NYC chair, Cardema is attempting to be the substitute nominee of the party list group Duterte Youth. He filed the bid on the eve of election and passed office hours. Pasaway!
Just this week, the bid was approved by Commission on Elections. Now, why is this move problematic?
First of all, overage na si Kuya. He is beyond the age limit to represent a youth group. Balikan natin yung ating batas. Klarong-klaro po. Section 9 of the Party List System Act states that a nominee of the youth sector must at least be 25 but not more than 30 years of age on the day of the election. 30 years po yung upper limit. Let's not forget that. So, ilang taon na nga ba si Cardema ulit? Base sa kanyang Facebook, he was born on April 13, 1986. That makes him 33 years old, which means he is 3 years over the age limit. Guys, it's just simple math. The second issue is yung biglang pag-withdraw ng lahat ng other nominees of the Duterte Youth Party List. Guys, balikan natin ulit yung batas. Klarong-klaro, Section 8 of the Party List Act states that substitution is only allowed if the nominee dies, as in patay po, and withdraws his or her nomination in writing or becomes incapacitated. Kung papansinin nyo, none of this applied in the case of Ronald Cardema, ang kanyang asawa na original first nominee ng Duterte Youth Party List. But even if the substitution was allowed, Cardema will not automatically become the first nominee. Rather, he will take the fifth spot. At ito pa, the fifth nominee can't even take a seat dahil the Duterte Youth Party List only won a single seat in the Congress. So this is what happened. Sabay-sabay nag-withdraw ang limang nominees ng Duterte Youth Party List, paving the way for Cardema to be the first on the list. Parang ang sketchy, no? Ayon kay Cardema, nag-backout silang lahat dahil na cold feet. Pero iba naman yung na-discover ng verifiers upon double-checking the notice of withdrawal records. One nominee said he wants to work unnoticed and away from public opinion. Ayon naman dun sa isa pang nominee, she said that she rather leave policymaking to quote-unquote intelligent minds in the group. Yung isa naman sabi niya, he wants to keep his privacy. And another nominee stated that she is considering taking a job abroad. Ayon naman sa misis ni Cardema, she feels that her husband will be the best person for the job, hence her withdrawal. Kaya sabi tuloy ni election lawyer Emilio Marañon III, this move is, quote-unquote, a clear attempt to circumvent the prohibition on the alteration of the order of nominees. Para silang nasa mahabang pila tapos may biglang sisingit kasi daw parang may nag-save ng pwesto para sa kanya. Medyo BV, di ba? Ibang issue pa ang conflict of interest. During the campaign season, election watchdog group Contradaya actually asked Cardema to resign or temporarily leave his post as the chairman of the National Youth Commission. Kasi he's also the chairman of the Duterte Youth Movement. Potentially, may election offense dito dahil si Cardema may have allegedly used his position as the NYC chair to campaign for the Duterte Youth Party List group. According to the Constitution and Omnibus Election Code, no officer or employee in the civil service shall engage directly or indirectly in any electioneering or partisan political campaign. It remains to be seen if Cardema will be held accountable for a potential election offense. And fourth, we'll just pose this question. Does the substitution bid of Cardema comply with the essence of the party list system, which is to provide representation of marginalized groups across the country? That's for you guys to think about. We look forward to your views and opinion in the comments section.